Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about a real and reactive power control of three-phase grid-connected inverter. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So this is a simulation model or Simulink model used for testing the three-phase grid-connected inverter for real and reactive power control. So in order to design this grid-connected inverter, so you have to design this LCL filter. So based upon a DC source voltage and then AC voltage and then that means grid voltage, grid frequency and then power rating. Okay. So here we are using these equations for designing that LCL filter. So first we are using a 20 kVA, okay, 20 kVA design. So in order to design that LCL filter, we have to convert that 20 kVA into single phase. So that's why we are dividing that 20 kVA into 3, and then the DC voltage is we are consider is 1000 volt, and then switching frequency of the inverter is 5 kHz, and then single phase voltage is 480 divided by square root of 3, and then grid frequency is 50. So this is ripple inductor current. So this is a calculation for L1, L2 and C. So this is frequency, resonance frequency. So this resonance frequency should be in between FG and FSS. Okay. So this is a design equation for a LCL filter. So I am going to simulate this one. Now you can see that the resonant frequency is around 1.2 kHz. So is in between FG and FSS. Okay. And then this is a value for L1, L2, C. That means filter, inductor, filter and capacitor filter value. The same value we are using here. L1, L2 and then C. Okay. So this value is taken from this program. Okay. Coding L1, L2, C, and then we have DC voltage 1000 volt, and then we are using universal bridge 3-phase IGBT diode inverter, and this one used for measuring the inverter voltage and current, and this one used for measuring the grid voltage and current. So this, here we are using 480 volt grid with the 50 hertz frequency. So in this point we are connecting the load. So this is used for measuring the voltage and current of the load. So we are having 3-phase load. The rating is 480 volt 50 hertz. So 10 kilowatts we are using. And here we are measuring the inverter real and reactive power. So our VG, so taken from the grid side, that means voltage of the grid side. IN nothing but inverter current, right? We are taking inverter current. So here we are using power measurement unit to measure the real and reactive power. So here we are having real and reactive power of the inverter. So here we are measuring the real and reactive power of the load. Okay. So finally you have real power PL and reactive power QL of the load. So here we can see the real and reactive power of the load. So this inverter is going to be controlled by means of feed forward decoupling control. So in order to apply that feed forward decoupling control, we have to use EQ transformation. So for that we are measuring the grid voltage here. This grid voltage is going to be processed via PLL. So this PLL will be generate the omega t. So omega t nothing but the phase angle with respect to time. And then the grid voltage is going to be converted into ABC to DQ naught. That means by using DQ transformation. So from that we are measuring VD and VQ for the feed forward compensation concept. So this will be used for during implementation of feed forward compensation. And then here we are going to control the inverter current. So for the, we have to measure the inverter current here. So this inverter current should be converted into DQ not form. So for that we are using DQ transformation from ABC to DQ not, and then omega T is going to be taken from here. So finally we have ID IQ of the inverter current. So here we are measuring the single phase voltage and current, and then finally we have that the single phase voltage and current here. So now to check the phase angle of the that voltage and current, whether the inverter going to supply real power or reactive power. Okay, so you have to check that condition. We are measuring this voltage and current, single phase voltage and current. So next we move on to feed forward compensation. Here we are going to, that means this inverter going to be operated, so based upon this load requirement, right? So based upon this load requirement, we are going to control this inverter. So for that we are measuring PL and QL. So that PL, by using the PL QL, we have to convert it into reference current, right? So that PL is multiplied with the 2/3 and divided by VD. Okay, so here we are getting ID reference. So ID reference nothing but the magnitude current of the real power load. So here we are having QL, reactive power of the load, is multiplied with the 2/3 and divided by the VD, and here we are having IQ reference. So IQ reference nothing but the magnitude current of the reactive power load. So next here we are having ID IQ of the inverter. So this ID IQ going to be combined with the ID reference, IQ reference. After that going to be processed via PA controller. So this PA controller will be generate the control signal. So the value for the PA controller is the 25 and 500. So here we have two control signal from that PA controller. It will be added with, so here only we are applying that feed forward compensation or decoupling decoupling control concept. So here we are separating this control signal with the IQ omega L. So this is nothing but omega L 2 pi F L. So L nothing but 0.011, that means addition of L1 and this L2. Okay, is going to be separated with this control signal. Finally the outcome of this summing block going to be added with the VD. Okay, so this is the final control signal in the form of direct access. So the second control signal is going to be added with this ID omega L. Okay, and final outcome of this sum going to be added with the VQ. So the output of this sum will be, summer will be, is a final control signal in the form of Q axis. Okay, so this is nothing but a feed forward decoupling control. Okay, so finally you have control signal in the form of D and the Q axis. So that going to be converted into actual ABC. So here we are having DQ not to ABC conversion. So omega T going to be taken from the PLL. Okay, the final control signal in the form of ABC, it going to be processed via PWM generator. So here PWM generator, we are using two level PWM generator. It will generate 6 pulse. Okay, and carrier frequency here we are consider as 5 kilohertz. Okay, so this output pulse going to be is given to this inverter, okay, 3-phase inverter. So based upon this PWM pulse and control decoupling control concept, right, the inverter can supply a real power and a reactive power to the load based upon this load condition. Okay, so next we are going to test the model. So here we are having real power load 10 kilowatts. Okay, now we are going to check the system. Okay, I'm going to simulate the model. So here you can see that, so this is power from the inverter. So real power is 10 kilowatt, load having real power is 10 kilowatt. So reactive power from the inverter is 0, the reactive power, so reactive power of the load is 0. And here you can see that the phase angle, right, the phase angle difference between this voltage current is 0, right, both are in phase. So that mean that inverter only supplying the real power to the load side or grid side, okay. So now I'm going to adding the reactive power in this system. That mean I'm going to add reactive power around another 10 kilowatt, right. I'm going to add 10 kilowatt in the system. Let me check the results of the now you can see that the real and the reactive power of the load, right, is around 10 kilowatt. So here you can see that the real power supplied from the inverter is 10 kilowatt and reactive power supplied from the inverter is around 10 kilowatt, okay. And also you can see that phase angle difference between the voltage and current, right. So you can see the phase angle difference, there is an it has some phase angle difference because now that inverter, three-phase inverter supplying the real and reactive power to the grid side or load side, right. So that's why the voltage and current having the phase angle difference, okay. So from that you can easily see that whether that inverter is working in that in supplying real power or real and reactive power, okay. So next I'm going to check the same system with the change in load condition also. So I'm going to make a real power load and then I'm going to take another load. It going to be connected via circuit breaker, okay. So I'm going to use circuit breaker here. So I'm going to connect this load to the this point and then I'm going to close the circuit breaker after 1 second. So we will check the results. So when load is added to the system, right, the inverter should supply that load demand, okay. So we will check the results. So now the power is 10 kilowatt. So the 10 kilowatt is supplied from the inverter. After 1 second, the load changed to 20 kilowatt. So now the inverter also supplying the 20 kilowatt, right, for changing load condition. That means whether we are going to change the load in between our design value, right, 20 kVA, right. So the inverter inverter can supply the demanded power, okay. So this is a working of that model. And also you can check that the current of the inverter, right. Up to 1 second it is having the current relevant to the 10 kilowatt. After 1 second, right, the power is changed from 10 kilowatt to 20 kilowatt. So that's why the current supplied from the inverter going to be increased, right. So this working of three-phase inverter, that means real and reactive power control of three-phase grid-connected inverter in the MATLAB simulation. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.